Hey everyone, hope you're having a great day. I know I am. Today I wanted to talk to you about a topic we've touched on before as it relates to self-love, but today I wanted to focus on love. And it's love as it relates to your family, your friends, your children, of course, but what I wanted to focus on is being in love. You know, that feeling, that magical feeling that we are all seeking and searching for. It's a beautiful thing. And I think it's kind of gotten diluted because we've become fallen in love with the idea of being in love, that we're not so much focused on the love anymore. And we have all these criteria of what it means to be in love and what another person has to do to show that they're in love. And what we've done is we've forgotten what true love is. And true love to me is number one, accepting people with their flaws. Gosh, I know I am super flawed. I am quirky. And the person who, you know, decides to fall in love with me with all those quirks and flaws, I'll know it's true love. And the same goes for you. You can't expect a person to be perfect. And we've been conditioned and taught that they have to be this way or they have to be that way. And what you're doing is you are forcing a situation. You're trying to change someone, which isn't fair to them. And if you can't accept them with their flaws, maybe that isn't love, and maybe that's not the person for you, and it's time to go find the right person. But when you can accept a person with their flaws, and when you're with a person that is true love, you're in love with, I believe that they bring out the best in you, and you become your best version, the best version of yourself possible when you're with them, and vice versa. And to me, that's what love is. When you are the best version of yourself because of their energy, because of what they bring out in you. And we, again, have all these expectations. Oh, he bought me flowers. That must mean he loves me. Oh, I took him on vacation. I must love him. And none of that matters. That's all great stuff. But those aren't benchmarks. Those aren't things that tell you. Some people show their love differently. Some people don't even say, I love you. But if you are listening and you are aware and you are truly in love with the person, you'll know their love language. You'll know when they're doing subtle things that show you how they feel about you. So you have to get out of your own head and what you want from the person, because that's not true love. That's wanting something to fill something up in you and let them be who they are. And then of course, it's super important for you to open your heart, be really vulnerable, and give of yourself over and over and over again, and just let the cup run over and just keep giving. And of course, if you're not getting anything back, it probably means you're not in the right relationship. But if you do keep doing that, and you will get stuff back if you're in the right relationship, and you'll start to feel that love, and it'll be magical because you'll have opened this door and they'll be responding, and the flow between the two of you will be so awesome. So I hope you liked this video and got some good tips, and I cannot wait to hear about your love. So definitely share with me and have a great day.